right, we're clear. Just got to get out of here now. There's a little on the... Oh, that's all right. We're quite close to the wall. We're good, though. Yeah, we're good. Nothing comes whizzing around the corner.
After 200 feet, turn right for cross. Turn right.
Really don't want to be holding you up, my friend. Only an hour in there. What is going there? Good man. Thank you. We'll take nobody's wing mirror. We're good. Yeah, he did say you can go the other way. He said it's a bit tight. Yeah. So we went the best way.
After 300 feet, turn right.
Turn right. Phew. Nice people in there, family firm. Nice talking to the son.
Turn right.
Really nice bloke. Really nice bloke. Really nice people, actually, all round. They have a couple of lads in there. Absolutely spot on. Quite happy to go there again. Do you know when you go somewhere, they go, first thing they say is, all right, drive, how you doing? Yeah, I'm good, yeah. Like a cup of tea or a cup of coffee? Oh, well, thank you very much. Do you know what I mean? That's so rare. So rare. Right, now there's some low branches on this side of the road, I saw. We might be doing some overhead branch cutting. Yeah, got that one. Might get some here. Come on, Benny. Oh, I'm starving, hungry. River around here somewhere, down in there, yeah. Let them out. There's a car park at the back now, I could have parked in. That'd be right, wouldn't it? The Finch Foundry. Ah. What a lovely little village. He was telling me that he wanted to live in the village. He grew up here. Wanted to live in the village, but couldn't afford to.
After 600 feet, bear right.
So they had to live in Oakhampton. Him and his girlfriend live in Oakhampton. Because they just can't afford anything within the village. Which is a shame, isn't it?
Right.
I see no bears. I'm glad I'm empty. Branches here. Noticed them on the way down. see this derelict barn up here. Overhanging branches, could do it having bottoms cut back. How about the top bits? There's that barn there. Make a cute little house. Warning, I'm about to crash into a car apparently. That's a nice house there, that's a big old pad there, blimey.
After 900 feet, go straight on B3260.
Oh yeah, we turned off last time. Work out how to get back across the road.
Go straight on.
Straight on. No little lay-by on the left, is there? No. Let's have a look at the HGV truck parking in there. There is parking there. Awkward to get in and out. Oh my word. Get yourself blocked in there, well and truly.
After 900 feet, sharp right, A30, towards Exeter.
Oh, look at that. Exeter.
Sharp right.
Get halfway across the road there. Oh, that's a little bit, yeah, we're right. No curbs, but. And away we go! Whee! Turn to 10.
Follow A30 towards Exeter for 21 miles.
Just away, going back the way we came up to Exeter, then I'll be coming off and heading cross country. I suspect this will be part two of the video. quite a nice way back. As soon as I get near Exeter, I'll turn you off. And then there's a few bits and pieces as we go through, sort of Lyme Regis or Axminster and Lyme Regis, and through what's the place? Through the Bride Valley and Bridport, that's it. By Bailey. So a nice little run back. Roads are quite quiet, to be totally honest with you. I know it's sort of half term, I think, this week. There doesn't seem to be a great deal on the roads. So either everyone's on holiday, but they're staying at home, or they've already got where they're going and they're not moving around. Maybe it's the old cost of living crisis that's keeping people from moving. Go for any more rain. Westfield's another red booth outfit. See their trucks all over the place. So I've just been, I was a new one, never been there before. You know, it was quite easy, you just you had to get into their yard, which was a little, well, not really tight. Now I was quite lucky. I managed that the trailer was, the box was light, so I managed to shrink the trailer to be able to manoeuvre myself around the yard, which made life a little bit easier, all apart from when I got into some gravel and then all the weight in the back. It still sort of made it a bit tricky when you've got a bit of a lock on to get any purchase, all the weight's in the back end. So yeah, we got it, we got through it. Any more weight than that, then I wouldn't do it with any more than about, like I say, 5-6 ton there. That'd be about it. Anything more than that, I'd have to struggle to get the full container, full stretch trailer out. Not much to see along here, so it's just dual carriageway. And we're sort of like entombed with the green hedges, so I'll put you on a little bit later, there'll be better roads to drive along. I'll speak to you later. Hello, just going across the raised section at Exeter. Whether you'll get a bit of a better view here or not, I don't know. More traffic now. So we're on the M5, northbound. Road before the motorway was put in place. There was three pallets trucks down in the services when I left this morning. He's tipped his way back up. That's the same one. One out of three. Coming off, move over a lane. To my left. A little bit if I don't move over now.
After half a mile, take the exit 29 A30 towards Honiton. Then, at the end of the road, turn left.
It's another one of these roads where it sort of goes corkscrews round on yourself.
Take the exit 29. Then, at the end of the road, turn left.
Gentle. let's just spit us out on the A30.
Turn left, A30, towards Honiton, then keep right.
Get on the road for the A30, not the Science Park. And then we'll run up next to the Exeter Airport. Good.
After 600 feet, keep right.
Keeping right. Oh, cheeky.
Well, that wrong, didn't keep you? Right. Follow A30 Honiton Road towards Honiton for 14 miles.
Right, I'll speak to you all a little bit later, probably when we get to Honiton. I'll speak to you later.
A35 towards Dorchester. Slow traffic on A35. Traffic jam ahead between Shedbush Lane and A35 Main Street. 4 minutes delay.
Not sure, he's lost a tyre. Lost a tyre. So that's where you need the highways agency there to do that. Stick cones out and put some flashing lights on. Do you need to use the resources of a copper? Not really. So we're just coming off now. It's a long drag up the hill, so stay with us for a few minutes.
After half a mile, sharp left, A35, towards Dorchester. Slow traffic on A35. Traffic jam ahead between Gibbs Lane and Apple Trees Lane. 4 minutes delay. No sharp one. Left.
So again, another corkscrew back on yourself. But not much of a slip road to actually bring your speed down. Easily get caught out if you're not paying attention, as you can tell by the way the signs are beaten up. How many people have gone through them and all the tyre marks there, look. Honiton. The road. These hills aren't going to cause us too much of a problem because we're emptying them, especially as there's only
after
a 20 foot box.
Feet, go left on the roundabout and take the first exit, A35, towards Dorchester. Low traffic on A35. Traffic jam ahead between Star Lane and Arundel. 4 minutes delay.
I've only come this way once with Clay and never again.
Left on the roundabout and take the first exit.
Oh, we've got a clear run. Let's go. No curbs. Excellent. Then part of Dorchester.
Follow A35 King's Road towards Dorchester for 14 miles.
Castle. It used to be pink. Painted it white now.
traffic on A35. Traffic jam ahead between New Street Lane and A35C Road South. 2 minutes delay.
I wonder if there's traffic lights up here because of the subsidence. Traffic lights up here for ages. Here is popping. Along here somewhere, maybe I was oh, it was here there, yeah, so the traffic jam is not there. Dirty Virga van, we'll be pulling over as long as it's on my side of the road. Yeah, but I don't think you can't park a truck there. I'm sure there's one here. Yeah, all day breakfast, shop and cafe. How am I going to get in there? Burger van down in this lay-by. The lay-by's on the wrong side of the road. Lunch in that pub before. I don't know if it's got new owners or not, but it wasn't really up to much. It's a good few years ago. Nice and steady here. Thank you. a bit narrow, even you meeting another car, it gets a bit tight. Must be further on then. Just get to the other side of these bushes, I can get over a bit. Gone up to a 13 minute delay now. Great views though. Starbucks, 400 metres to my left. No hope of getting in there. Not that I'd want a Starbucks. Cheers. In there. Get over. Tree stinks there. is where the this is where the burger van used to be, down here on the right, I'm sure it is. Hell of a drop on the left though. Jeez. Burger van in there. Not anymore. There is a cafe down here on the right, but again it's like a garage on the side of the road. Greg's here as well. That's new. Greg's, I think. The old inn. So where am I going to go? And how do I get in there? That ain't going to happen, is it? Crazy. We did have a whole stream of traffic behind us, we've only got one now. Over the River Axe. Which goes through Axminster, famous for its carpets. Long drag up the hill again now. Bloody starving! Ah, just what we need. But it might just be just at the right time. I don't reckon I can get by him. I've got no hope. I've got no hope. I might be able to get by him now. It's got half of it hanging out the roof. Steeper than it looks. I'm still doing 40 mile an hour. If I was loaded, I'd be down to about 17, 18 mile an hour now. Cruise control decided to switch itself off. Drop power. Thank you. Think about it. And the sun's coming out.
Whee!
Raymond's Hill. He was Raymond. Why did he have a hill named after him? Pub. Here's a poppin. I'm going to be unlucky to get something to eat. There's a burger bar when you come out of Dorchester. It's normally pretty busy, and it is a bit of a bugger getting out of it. You've got to be let out rather than being able to get out. Back in the tires then. I'm a Dorset lad. Born in Shaftesbury. Spent the early years in Charred Oakford and then Shaftesbury. We were saying that I've lived in the house we're in at the moment. I've lived there for 9 years. The same, I moved when Kira moved into it. I moved in with her, and 9 years. It's the longest I've ever lived in one place, by a long shot. Probably about two to three years in any one place over the course of 50 odd years, nearly 48 years. So this is the longest I've ever lived in one place. Been on the run, that's what it is. Been an outlaw. Quite have. Well, yeah. It was a stage of my life where I didn't want to be pinned down. Oh, that's behind me now. She had a rake of them. Reverse thrusters on. Go right, I think it takes us to if I'm at the right place, takes us down the line Regis.
After a quarter of a mile, cross the roundabout and take the second exit, A35, towards Morecambe Lake. Slow traffic on A35. Traffic jam ahead. Between New Street Lane and B3157 Burton Road, 6 minutes delay.
Bit of extra brake, yeah.
Cross the roundabout and take the second exit.
Train is jagging. And on we go.
Follow A35. 5 towards Morecambe Lake for 7.5 miles.
Well, I don't really want to turn you off, but it's just like one nice view after the next, isn't it? I've run out of memory card. If I do, I do. I download everything tonight. I do have about 3 other memory cards. Silage, isn't it? Look at it, tons of it. What are they making hay? Is it hay now? Need a bit more sun. Foot boxes going along here, probably all empty, going to get clay. Traffic coming the other way. Like in these roads. This is the Moore's Biscuit Factory, where they make the famous Dorset Nub. Nothing like. Everyone likes a bit of Dorset Nub. Moore's Biscuits, look. I've heard that once you've had a bit of Dorset Knob, a that's all you ever want. I can see the sea to my right, you can't, I can. Downhill again now. It's being a bit ginger in this car. Good for me. Change this to a 30 now. Well, they're going to be unlucky because I'm trying to keep it on 30, I'm 30 now, but they're getting away from me, and there's a speed camera down here. You crack on. That's supposed to be gravel traps there. There we are in Chittick. She didn't like it up her. Beautiful houses, but who wants to live on, again, it's like, who wants to live on this road? It's quite a few houses, see, that's sold, but yeah, there's me rattling by you. Yeah. Oh, now the bus has decided to stop. Oh, and you've got, oh my word of life. Yep. Stick a high vis on though, fella. He seemed quite happy. Is the old George in? George III. Drag up the hill now. Gotta be careful, it's still a 30 mile an hour limit here. And there is a camera just to my right, just in front of where that blue car is coming out the drive. Easy to go, oh, I'll get my foot down and get going. No.
Slow traffic on A35. Traffic jam ahead between A354 Moncton Hill and A354 Moncton Hill. 2 minutes delay.
I don't know where Moncton Hill is. It is tight for you. Thankfully, I'm empty. Coming the other way here. Yeah? Don't really want to be meeting anything. We're good. tipper. Well, he's not going to give a shit, is he? Plenty of room. Oh, then we got a car park. Stopping there. How much? All that, but he could have pulled over a little bit more, couldn't he? Dropping down now into West Bay. Oh, Bridport. Go through Bridport, so I'll probably turn you off now and turn you back on again as I climb up out of Bridport. Old police van there. I'm only doing 49. So I'll speak to you all in a bit. Summer season is here. Look at this lot.
Slow traffic on A35. Traffic jam ahead between Tilly Wynn Lane and A354 Moncton Hill. 5 minutes delay.
So this is a Bridport bypass. You get down here and turn right. I haven't been into Bridport in quite a while.
After 900 feet, go right on the roundabout and take the third exit, A35, towards Winterbourne Abbas. Go right on the roundabout and take the third exit.
Nowhere to stop. Not for a poor hungry truck driver. Get over my bike.
Follow A35 East Road towards Winterbourne Labbers for 13 miles.
And this is why I don't come this way during the day, because it would be just like yesterday afternoon, it'd be like this. Absolutely solid. He's in a whole world of his own there, on his phone, by Uncle Ina. This goes on for. Just a bit. Right, it's got some climbing to do now. The sea is just over to our right, not far away.
behind us. Somebody coming up, but...
get the other side of Dorchester. If I don't find anything, I get the other side of Dorchester, pull up in the lay-by. I need a pee anyway. 15. Have some yogurt. Oh, I like yogurt, don't get me wrong. I could have really done with a dirty burger, you know what I mean? Well, I hope you're enjoying this. I've ridden all these roads on a Honda C90. Finished climbing yet. Does it? It never does it justice, does it? Still climbing. Dorsetshire at its finest. Can you see them on right? You can't see that. Lovely little fountain, lovely little villages tucked down in the valleys, either side of these hills. It's like the land Tom's forgotten. Time and land's forgotten, yeah. Is it? Which way about you say that? At the top. Nearly. Last little bit. Spectacular. cock. Dips. Quite like a hidden dip. Guacamole, salsa, cream cheese, chives and onions. Oh, don't. I'm starving. If only I could come across a hidden dip right now. Nowhere to stop. You know, we've gone from Exeter Services was the last place I could have realistically pulled over. Shite, innit? There's been lay-bys, but there's nothing in them. Nowhere to get anything to go, nowhere to go to the toilet, nowhere to get anything to eat. Yeah, being a trucker is wonderful. You get to see some fantastic views though, don't you? Yeah. And this route is called the Jurassic. Where's he going? Jurassic Coast all along here. And I get to drive it. Son, you can do it. Swing around. Popping up that road. Well, once I get up, go through this village, there isn't a lot more to see, really. Well, there is, but it's pretty tame after this, I must admit. It's quite boring. So. Well, I think I'll end it there. That's a good old video. It's part two of my trip to Devon. We'll get over, you know. See, I think there's something here on the right, but how on earth am I supposed to get into there? Oh no, that's not. It's not even it. What it is now. sure that used to be a little chef. Coach house, that's had some work done to it. Wow. There's a garage up here, Bride Valley Motors. What used to be Bride Valley Motors? It used to be a Renault dealership at one stage. Pulled in here one day and it didn't have any diesel. Not in the truck, not out in the car. Now this is when I first started working for this firm. I had an old DAF, 15 plate DAF. I had a load of clay on the back. This is the only time I've come back this way with clay. And it was really slow here. And I think I got to about halfway up this hill and it just ground to a halt and stopped. I had to go in the crawler. It just got to here. I said, oh, no, I'm not doing it anymore. That's it. Finished. Right, well, that was about it, really. That's, the rest of this is fairly, it's quite pretty. It is pretty, isn't it, you know? I'll get to the top of this hill, that's about it. Well, yeah, down here, there's a pallet man down here, he does all the pallets. Well, he used to, has he still got pallets in there? Yeah. Obviously done all right for himself, look at his house. Pack of pallets. Right, beautiful day, sunny. As to me, it's in Dorset. It's always sunny in Dorset. Now we're just about to come into Dorchester. I'll just show you Poundbury. There's a McDonald's up here as well. Now, can't get in there with a truck, can't get anywhere near it. There's not even any parking anywhere near it. Nah, it's boring. Anyway, I will speak to you later once I know what I'm doing. I might give them a call in a bit. It's a bit early though, they won't have a clue. So it's a bit of a waste of time really. So anyway, I will speak to you once I know what I'm doing. So I'll speak to you later. Oh, excuse me. Right. So, what time is it? Got 3 minutes left yet, actually. Took a 15. So got a message from the gorgeous Kira. Message from the gorgeous Kira. Love you. She's a cutie. How nice is that? That's what keeps you going sometimes, isn't it? What keeps you going. So we're heading back now to get this box off. I've made a phone call and they seem to know what I'm doing tomorrow. It hasn't been confirmed yet, but it looks like I'm doing a get this box off and back to the yard, refuel, park up under the docks for 2 o'clock. Yeah, 2 o'clock in the morning. Leicester drop and swap, nice and easy, not going to moan about that. So we're nearly, what time is it now? About a minute left, 13. Cool. When you, when you don't want it to finish, it finishes like finishes straight away, doesn't it? But when you're saying, oh, come on, it takes for ages to okay, just checking my pay slip. Yeah. That's all right. So we've got 14, about a minute to go. Straight into the container yard, just round the corner from us. I'm hoping to be parked up by about 2 o'clock, which would be nice if I've on the docks at 2 o'clock tomorrow morning. Just had something to eat. I actually had chicken tikka slice, so I've eaten that and some cold meats to go along with it. I need to get the Hoover out in this truck. It is absolutely covered in all sorts. You wouldn't want to drop anything on the floor and pick it up and go, oh, it's the 5 second rule. Whoa, not in here, you wouldn't. It would cover you, pick it up, be area and more cat. Well, I've just realised. I've got to change this. I've just realised I've got my t-shirt on inside out. Oh, what a state I am. Right, let's change that. Mind you, it's probably cleaner that way round. I think I've got my dinner down the front of it. There you go. Fucking mong. Well, we'll be on there. We're ready to go, yeah? 16, yeah, we can go. About a bit of ages. God, it's warm in here. Temperatures are kicking up. So yeah, did I say Leicester drop and swap? I think it's for 6 o'clock in the morning, but if I'm late, I'm late. I don't really care. Doesn't make a great deal of difference to them. Bit of a shame getting rid of this trailer. It's been a nice trailer, apart from the clankiness when it's empty. An easy up and down tomorrow, which should set me up nicely for Friday morning. Home at a sensible time, happy days. That's what it's all about. So I'm just going to enjoy the rest of the beautiful Dorset countryside as we head along the A35, all the way back towards Southampton, across a bit of the forest up through Ringwood, drop in. Down in through into Southampton, back to the yard. Yeah, happy days. So I will speak to you, maybe as we go across the forest, I don't know, at some point. Speak to you all later.